Education is not the learning of facts, but the training of the mind to think. So let's learn and enjoy mathematics. Our lesson is about probability of mutually inclusive and exclusive events. What could be our objectives? First, we will identify mutually inclusive and exclusive events. And second, we will determine the probabilities of mutually inclusive and exclusive events. So let us see what could be the mutually inclusive events. That is the overlapping of event A and event B. These are sets that share common elements. The mutually inclusive, they intersect on a Venn diagram and compound events that occur in the same time. So as you can see, we have the event A and event B. Event A is overlapped with the event B. They intersect in a Venn diagram. So what could be the formula? The formula for mutually inclusive events, that is the probability of A union B, it is equal to the probability of event A plus the probability of event B minus the intersection of event A and event B. So let us answer this one. So let us see what could be the A union B. The A union B, so let us see, in an event A, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5. While the event B, we have 4, 5, no need to write it again, and then 6, and then 7. How about the A intersection B? The A intersection B, that is the overlapping of event A and event B. So that is 4 and then 5. So let us see using the formula to get the mutually inclusive events of this Venn diagram. The formula, probability of event, it is equal to number of event outcomes all over total number of possible outcomes. So let us see. The probability of A union B, the event A, so if we count, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is 5 out of 11. How to get 11? Event A, 5. Event B, 4. And then outside the event A and B, that is 2. So 5 plus 4 plus 2, that is 11. So total number of possible outcomes, that is 11. How about the event B? The event B, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. All over total number of possible outcomes, that is 11. How about the probability of the intersection of event A and then event B? So we have 2, so 2 all over total number of possible outcomes, that is equal to 11. So let us solve. 5 plus 4, 9 minus 2, the answer is equal to 7 over 11. So the probability of A union B, that is equal to 7 over 11. So let us see example number 1. Consider the experiment of rolling a die. Find the probability of getting an even number or a number that is a multiple of 3. So let us see what could be the sample space. The sample space that is equal to 6 because the number from a die that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 6. So let us see how about the even number. The even number in a die that is 2, 4, 6. So we have 3 elements. How about the number that is a multiple of 3? So the multiple of 3, let us represent it with M. So 3 and then 6. So we have 2 elements. So let us find now the probability of an even number. Let us represent it with E. Or a number that is a multiple of 3. Let us represent it with M. So let us replace all the value to the given formula. So the given formula A, that becomes E. And then B, that becomes F. So it means probability of even number or a multiples of 3 equals probability of E plus the probability of M. So A is E, B is M, and then A intersection of B, that is E intersection of M. So let us solve. Probability of even number, that is equal to 3 elements all over 6 total sample space, plus the probability of the multiples of 3, that is 2 out of 6. The intersection of the even number and the multiples of 3, that is 6, so we have 1. So minus 1 over 6. 3 plus 2 is 5, minus 1, the answer is equal to 4 over 6. Lowest term of 4 over 6, that is equal to 2 over 3. 4 divided by 2 is 2. 6 divided by 2, the answer is equal to 3. So the probability of even number or a number that is multiple of 3, that is equal to 2 over 3. In example number 2, if a card is drawn from an ordinary deck of 52 cards, find the probability that the card is a face card or a black card. So what could be the sample space? The sample space that is equal to 52. So let us see how many face cards. So the face card, we have 4 king, 4 queen, and then 4 jack. How to get 4? Because we have spade, hearts, club, and then diamond. So it means 4 king, 4 queen, and then 4 jack. Total number of elements that is equal to 12. How about the black card? So the black card for the spade and club. So for the spade, so we have A, alas, king, queen, jack, 10 up to 2 if we count all in all. So that is equal to 13. Also in a club, king, queen, jack, 10 up to alas. So we have 13 cards. So let us find now. So if the black card is 13 plus 13, the answer is equal to 26. So let us find now the probability that the card is a face card or a black card. Let us represent it with the first letter, so that is F, and the black card, that is B. So let us find now the probability of the face card or a black card. So A, replace it with F, and B, replace it with B. So probability of the face card or a black card. So equals probability of F plus the probability of B minus the intersection of probability of F and then B. The probability of the face card, that is equal to 12 all over the total possible outcomes, that is equal to 52, plus 26 over 52, that is the black card, and the intersection of the face card and the black card, that is equal to 6 out of 52. Because in a spade and in a club, we have king, queen, and jack for the spade, and then another king, queen, and jack for the club. So 3 plus 3, the answer is equal to 6. So let us solve. 12 plus 26 minus 6, the answer is equal to 32 over 52. The lowest term of 32 over 52, that is equal to 8 over 13. Because 32 divided by 4 is 8, 52 divided by 4, the answer is equal to 13. So the probability that the card is a face card or a black card, that is equal to 8 over 13. How about example number 3? The probability that Joanna passes English is 0.4, and the probability that she passes in math is 0.7. If the probability that she passes both subjects is 0.3, what is the probability that she will pass at least one of these subjects? Let us see what could be the given. The given probability of English, so P of English, let us represent it with E, that is equal to 0.4. The probability that she passed math, let us represent math as M, that is equal to 0.7. And the intersection that she passes both subjects, that is equal to 0.3. So probability of the English intersect with math. So what could be the formula? So let us find first the probability of English union to math. So let us represent A with E while B with M. So probability of E union M, it is equal to probability of E plus the probability of M minus the intersection of E and M. The probability of English, that is equal to 0.4. The probability of math plus 0.7 minus the intersection of English and math, that is equal to 0.3. So let us solve. 0.4 plus 0.7 is 1.1. 1.1 minus 0.3, the answer is equal to 0.8. So the probability that she will pass at least one of these subjects is 0.8. What is mutually exclusive events? The mutually exclusive events sets that have no common elements. They never intersect on a Venn diagram, and it can happen at the same time. The mutually exclusive event, that is the disjoint sets. As you can see, in a Venn diagram, never intersect the event A and event B. So it means this one is the mutually exclusive events. So what could be the formula for the mutually exclusive events? The formula, probability of A union B, it is equal to the probability of A plus the probability of B. In event A, we have 1, 2, 3, while the event B, we have 4, 5, 6, 7, and outside the event A and event B, that is 8 and 9. Let us get the A union B. The A union B for the event A, we have 1, 2, 3, while the event B, we have 4, 5, 6, and then 7. So the A union B, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7. How about the A intersection of B? As you can see, in this one, the event A and event B, there is no overlapping. So it means A intersection of B, that is empty set, or pwede natin isulat na bracket only. So let us solve now the probability of an event for event A and event B. Number of event outcomes all over total number of possible outcomes. The formula, probability of A union B, it is equal to probability of A plus probability of B. It is applicable, this formula, if the given event is mutually exclusive or, as you can see, in a Venn diagram, that is disjoint sets. The probability of A, that is equal to 3 because 1, 2, 3 all over 9 if we count all the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Total number of possible outcomes, that is equal to 9. How about the probability of B? The probability of B, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, so 4 over 9. 3 plus 4, that is equal to 7, and then copy the same denominator. So, the probability of A union B, that is equal to 7 over 9. In example number 1, if a card is drawn from an ordinary deck of 52 cards, find the probability that the card is a diamond card or a black card. This example is a mutually exclusive event because there is no overlapping between the diamond and then the black card. So let us see what could be the sample space. The sample space, that is equal to 52. And then the diamond card, we have king, queen, jack, 10 up to ace, that is equal to 13 cards. How about the black card? The black card of the spade and then the club. The spade, we have ace, king, queen, jack, 10 up to 2. If we count all in all, that is equal to 13. And then the club, we have king, queen, jack, 10 up to ace. If we count all the clubs, that is equal to 13. So the black cards, 13 plus 13, the answer is equal to 26. Let us find now the probability of the card is a diamond card or a black card. Let us represent the diamond card with the first letter D and then the black card with the first letter B. So let us replace A by D and then B by B. So it means probability of the diamond card or a black card is equal to probability of the diamond card plus the probability of the black card. The probability of the diamond card, that is equal to 13 all over total sample space, that is equal to 52, plus the probability of the black card, that is equal to 26 all over 52. So 13 plus 26, the answer is equal to 39 over 52. The lowest term of 39 over 52, that is equal to 3 over 4. Because 39 divided by 13, that is equal to 3. 52 divided by 13, that is equal to 4. So the probability that the card is a diamond card or a black card, that is equal to 3 over 4. In example number 2, what is the probability that the standard deck of cards is a number from 3 to 6 or a face card? So let us see what could be the sample space. The sample space that is equal to 52 because we have the standard deck of cards. How about the other given? The given number that is 3 to 6. So 3, 4, 5, 6. So 3, 4, 5, 6 for heart, diamond, spade, and then club. So it means if this is 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 times 4, that is equal to 16. How about the face card? The face card, this is king, queen, and jack. Face card is king, queen, and jack for the spade, for the club, for the diamond, and then for the heart. So it means all in all, that is equal to 12. So let us find now the probability of the number from 3 to 6 or a face card. Let us represent the number by the first letter N and then the face card by F. Let us replace to the formula for the probability of mutually exclusive events. A by N, B by F. So probability of the number 3 to 6 or a face card, it is equal to probability of the number plus the probability of the face card. What could be the probability of the number? The number that is equal to 16 over 52 plus the probability of the face card that is 12 over 52. 16 plus 12, the answer is equal to 28 over 52. And the lowest term of 28 over 52, that is equal to 7 over 13. Because 28 divided by 4 is 7. 52 divided by 4, the answer is equal to 13. So the probability that the standard deck of cards is a number from 3 to 6 or a face card, that is equal to 7 over 13. In example number 3, what is the probability of drawing an ace or a king in a standard deck of cards? So let us see what could be the sample space. The sample space that is equal to 52 because we have the standard deck of cards. And then how about the ace? The ace is, as you can see, we have the ace for the spade, the heart, the diamond, and the club. So if we count, that is equal to 4. And then how about the king? The king, we have also 4 because for the spade, the heart, the diamond, and the club. So let us find now the probability of the ace or a king. Let us represent ace by the first letter A and then by the king by the first letter K. Let us replace A by A and then B by K. So let us find now the probability of the ace or a king in a deck of cards. So that is equal to probability of the ace plus the probability of the king. As you can see, there is no intersection between the ace and then the king. So the probability of the ace, that is equal to 4 all over total number of possible outcomes, that is equal to 52, plus the king, so plus 4 all over 52. 4 plus 4, the answer is equal to 8 over 52. And the lowest term of 8 over 52, that is equal to 2 over 13. Because 8 divided by 4 is 2, 52 divided by 4, the answer is equal to 13. So the probability of drawing an ace or a king, that is equal to 2 over 13. Instruction: give the probability of the following questions. Provide your answers in the comment section. Enjoy learning mathematics. I'm Teresa Tubal. Thank you so much.